Hello there. Welcome to another reading of Beyond the Story, a 10-year record of BTS, Bangtan Sonyeondan or Bulletproof Boy Scouts. I hope that you started the new year, 2024, on a high note. I guess maybe some of you have returned to work. Others have returned to school, and maybe there are still those who are still on holidays. But whatever it is that you are doing, I hope this year started on a high note and with much optimism, with much energy. And I hope you all are doing very well the start of the new year. So, we are still on chapter 6, the second to the last chapter of the book. And it is the chapter that is named The World of BTS. And the subheading that we're going to start today is Surfing USA. In 2017, BTS attended the Billboard Music Awards for the first time and won in the category of Top Social Artist. The following year, their BBMA's performance of Fake Love, BTS's very first performance at the BBMA, pushed them to the top of the Billboard 200. And in the 2019 event, the evening they performed Boy With Love, with Halsey joining them on stage, they not only won their third consecutive Top Social Artist Award, but also Top Duo / Group, one of the major awards of the night. Every time they took the BBMA's stage, their fame and the media's attention in America would take another giant step upwards. On May 15, local time, 2019, BTS appeared on The Late Show with Stephen Colbert on CBS. In introducing BTS, the television audience was informed that precisely 55 years, 3 months, and 6 days since the Beatles debuted in America, a new star from overseas had made landing on the same stage. There at the Ed Sullivan Theater, where the Beatles had made their American television debut, The Late Show with Stephen Colbert broadcast BTS's performance of Boy With Love in black and white, just like the Beatles had been 55 years ago. American mainstream media was now directly connecting BTS and ARMY with the Beatles and Beatlemania. But BTS could not simply sit back and enjoy the fuss the media were making. The busier the world got, the more they knew for sure what they needed to be doing. Suga recalls their feelings from that period in time. When we won that major award at the BBMAs, we did not have an emotion we could pin down like greatness, quote unquote, or whatever. Our tour was beginning in a few days. There was no time to sit back and enjoy the moment. I really like that about the seven of us. No matter where we are or what situation we're in, we're always the same. We don't think too much about it. Sugar laughs. Not that we don't appreciate the significance of the award. I just think we make an effort not to dwell on it too much. That's their humility right there. Those 7 year old men are so used to just working hard. You know, their work ethic is unparalleled. It's beyond, I think, normal, what's normal. And I think they don't let this fame thing, or whatever it is, because it still bewilders them. Why they got so famous. I think they really innately understand the pitfalls of fame, and they really want to just be regular guys. Like, I think it's a combination of, you know, they're just really very humble. They don't take, you know, this for granted. And I think the center for them of it all, the reason for their success, for them being BTS, is ARMY. They truly, truly embody this. You know, they do not exist because the only reason that they exist is ARMY. Perhaps the US, the advent of BTS was an invasion. Footnote: the British invasion spearheaded by the Beatles denotes a wave of popularity of British rock acts in America in the mid-60s. There was an invasion the likes of which had only been seen 55 years ago. But BTS had already been breaking unprecedented records in Korea since 2015, that is true. The Western media, and most probably of the Western public, those who are not aware of K-pop, probably just thought, oh, this is a new group that just, you know, came into being. You know, they knew nothing of the history of BTS. By that time, in 2017, you know, they could be considered veterans already by K-pop standards. Only a year before they took the stage at SNL or The Late Show with Stephen Colbert, they were experiencing the dark side of glory, to the point of thinking about breaking up. And so, the more they experienced ever greater by the year's success in America, the more they had the chance to really look at reality as it was. Suga recalls the following in their exchanges with American artists at the time. Until then, my image of pop stars were just quote-unquote pop stars, the people I grew up listening to and admiring. It's only right to be fascinated. I had this fantasy that they would be very different from me, but then I learned they really were not. On the outside, they ride expensive cars, wear gold chains, and have fancy parties every day. But a lot of it turned out to be just part of the business. It was work, quote unquote, for them, in other words. And if they couldn't afford the cars or jewelry, they would rent them to show them off. There was, shall we say, a shattering. My fantasies were just shattered. To BTS, their activities in America were not so much like the life of stardom, often seen in movies, but more like something they needed to continue getting through. As they went through their list of things they had to do, they were coming to the realization that their souls were not aiming for more and more success, but for something that was deep inside of themselves. J-Hope says, "Standing on all those American stages gave us a kind of vibe that was different from what we felt in Korea, because they're kind of freer over there. The more we got on television there, the more we felt affected by this vibe. The freedom vibe J-Hope felt then would influence his music later on. There's more to come on this, but his solo work, like the single Chicken Noodle Soup and the song Outro Ego from the album Map of the Soul 7, were the result of such sensibility that he honed during their activities in America. J-Hope continues, "There was definitely an influence there. It was the kind of valuable experience money cannot buy. Excuse me. I think that's why I feel so much affection for past moments like that, because those were the performances where I learned something big, something I had never felt before." Heading, subheading, Map of the Stadium. Jimin's inspirations from their American activities had a direct influence on BTS. As he attended the performances of various artists in America, he developed bigger artistic ambitions for BTS. "I kept comparing their performances to ours. I think every performance we saw in the States made me do this. One group would have
It was spectacular.
I think every performance we saw in the States made me do this. One group would have incredibly good dancers. Another artist would have an amazing concept. For example, there was one performance where everyone is dancing like at a party, and then they suddenly coordinate so that the main performer is highlighted in the crowd. I love that. There was even a performer who had really great staging and props. Jimin wanted to incorporate these feelings into BTS's performances. I began thinking our concert staging could be better. Seeing the greatest artists in the world performing live, so we began asking more from our own concerts. I kept talking about the need to go beyond where we were, to change our repertoire and improve our sets and production. The BTS World Tour Love Yourself, Speak Yourself, which ran from May 2019, was a performance that realized all of Jimin's hopes. As an expanded version of the BTS World Tour Love Yourself, the new tracks from Map of the Soul Persona were added to the setlist. The BTS World Tour Love Yourself, Speak Yourself was the first BTS tour that was all stadium appearances. This changed everything from the BTS World Tour Love Yourself that had ended just a month ago. The stages were larger, which meant the members had to create a performance that could fill them and be able to convey their vision to a much larger audience. Not only that, the performance at Wembley Stadium, which was slated to bring in the largest single audience of the tour at 60,000 people per date, was to be live-streamed the globe on VLive. Jungkook remembers what they were determined to do as they entered these arenas. "We were really nervous, but we went into these performances with the attitude of not being intimidated, but thinking, we're going to completely destroy this place. We kept our in-ear monitors out until the show began. Listen to the audience scream for one moment, put in our monitors, and gave it our all for the performance. Honestly, I think it was thanks to the members supporting each other that we were able to do a stadium tour, and I've got to do my part." BTS World Tour, Love Yourself, Speak Yourself, was not only one of the greatest moments in BTS history, but as Jungkook said, it was also a time when they needed to show the world why BTS were BTS. The crowds of people were enough to fill these stadiums, but BTS needed to deliver the show of a lifetime to make a truly memorable impression on audiences. Jimin says, "There are not many artists who can perform in front of 50,000 people, and I wanted to really leave a strong impression on everyone who came. We're really good. We're a seriously great team. I wanted to show everyone that." As Jimin had hoped, BTS World Tour, Love Yourself, Speak Yourself, delivered everything BTS were capable of. This performance begins with the song Dionysus or Dionysus from Map of the Soul Persona. Two gigantic leopard sculptures appear on stage, and BTS, atop a gigantic platform, give a powerfully energetic performance as countless dancers fill the stage. This is followed by Not Today, another song accompanied by the dancers in a large-scale spectacle. Around the middle of the show, the members leap around the stage, singing a medley of their hits including Dope, Silver Spoon or Bapse, and Burning Up Fire, while for the encore set, that opens with Anpan Man, the stage is turned into a playground. The magnitude of the stadium tour, the explosive performance of BTS, and the set list that leads up to the bright and energetic Anpan Man make the BTS World Tour Love Yourself, Speak Yourself set list a chronicle of their journey thus far. And after all those songs comes the finale, Microcosmos. And we will stop there. Until next time, thank you very much for spending time with me. It has been a pleasure. This is Beyond 1800 with BTS.